selling out a hitter doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's that made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
Yeah, whole club selling out a hitter doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. The whole club. Too white to be shooting in the eyes. I'm sleeping good at night. See the door don't got no locks. To be spiteful, she best friends with the ops. And did you need better stocks. Standing on my money, dog. Please don't get the involved. Ain't nobody running off. Rules to the basics. I can't be no son-in-law. I can't take the summer off. I make it look good and all, but this is no vacation. All the goons, they respect me and I know it. Watch your words and your tongue, you're not a poet. My advice, please don't try to be heroic. Let me know they
whole club selling out a hitter doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
Yeah, whole club selling out a hitter doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. That's what made me rich. Never had a mentor, only watched Scarface. I met her at a club. She twerked better when her heart breaks. Hey, hey, put the one on one of everything that I can. I'm praying for a Bentley and to never go to jail. I'm fresh up out the gutter, I don't know if you can tell. I'm hustling for everything I do. For legacy, you can call me any type of day, my dog. I never sleep. The only rule I got is if we don't embarrass me. I write down my problems, then record it just for therapy, just for clarity. Whole club selling out a hitter doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. Yeah, whole club selling out a hitter doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. Talk about it, that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich, the whole club.
What you mean you don't know how I'm stepping? What you mean you don't know what I'm repping? I'm good in my hood like they call me the blessing. You jacking my side, you gotta come and check in. At the way it get hectic, don't make me slide up on you, no electric. You hit him like a Tetris. You felt the way and know you do it texting. Listen, I don't know why they mentioning beef. I don't think no one better than me. You can say what you want, but my step was on speak. If I tell them to go, then they stepping on three. Like, boy, the chain, that's competitive. Me making rain in your hood like I weather the streets. So my label, we good, I'ma get to the breach. You only as tough as your weapon could be. I done got me a deal and I got off the block. Took the hate and put that in the watch. Had the ice on my neck, cause little shorty on hot. Shaking their hearts every time that I drop, like they gotta step in the field. I got time to play. And my exes are dumb, they have time to wait. Blocking that slide, I need time away. Like, what you mean you don't know how I'm stepping? What you mean you don't know what I'm repping? I'm good in my hood, like they call me the blessing. You jacking my side, you gotta come and check in. That's the way it get hectic. Don't make me slide up on you, no electric. Blocking hit them like it's Tetris. You felt the way and all you do is text and listen.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, where we'll see two of the NFL's oldest and most storied franchises. It's the Detroit Lions and the Green Bay Packers on Thursday night.
This place first opened way back in 1957. We are inside legendary Lambeau Field here in Green Bay. Tonight on this coming Thursday night, we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Detroit Lions taking on the Green Bay Packers. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Well, Charles, the page has been turned here in Green Bay, coming off a disappointing end to 2022 and a sub-500 finish. But set the quarterback position aside, what needs to happen for the Packers to get back to the NFC playoffs?
Everyone is...
Two teams that have met at least twice a year since 1932. The Lions and Packers underway from Lambeau. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. So here are the new-look Packers set to go to work. And at the helm here in 2023, a lot of eyes on this man in his fourth NFL season, Jordan Love.
This is set up now to be the true beginning of Love's NFL career, because he's finally out from under the shadow of Aaron Rodgers, and Green Bay is giving him this season to prove he can be their starter. 4 years after he was drafted in the first round, we're talking about Love as the next decade-long starter for the Green Bay Packers.
5 yards on the game's first play, second down.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken.
Ball on the 27. Here's second and five. Here's Love. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Aleem McNeil, what an effort to get in there and drop it. But just two plays in, and Charles already their first sack defensively.
Yeah, how about that? That didn't take long, did it? And now they look at third down, and that's another time to try and go and get the quarterback, too.
On third down, Love. That's taken in by the tight end, Josiah DeGrom. And he goes out of bounds, just shy of the 45. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
But when you hit him on the move like that, he's able to get him to open field with a full head of steam. Oh, boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. First down, going to the air with Love. That's caught by the rookie, Jaden Reed. 15 more there, and they're on the roll. It's another first down.
And every time you step off the field, coaches are always going to talk about how important tackling is in a ball game. And this one, especially so. You can't allow these guys to break free and get extra yards after contact, but that's exactly what happens here. That can't continue
as this game goes on.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
From the 38 now, here's a second down and six.
Keep it together, offense. Keep it together.
Again, it's Jones. And tough sliding.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five. To throw now. Here's Love. He finds his man. So far, Charles, they've moved this football into field goal range, but you know that they want to cap this off with six and not three.
Absolutely. As one of the better coaches in the league always tells me, on offense, I want to throw body blows all game long and finish it with uppercuts. Well, here are the body blows right now. He's hoping one uppercut will take care of the end of this drive.
Derek Barnes in on the stop.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front.
big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
From the 23, here's second and six. Now Love. He finds his man complete. That's Reed. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. They clearly wanted to come out, Charles, and be aggressive throwing the football, and they've been pretty efficient along with that aggressiveness. He's now 4 of 4 on this opening drive.
Yeah, and that's led to a fresh set of downs. I like what he's doing back there. You can tell he's at ease. Feels good about what he's doing. I think if I'm the play caller, I'm reading that. I'm continuing to let him throw the football.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Well, it's like that at just about every position. And sometimes if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
And he is going to lose yardage here. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
And the Lions going with an extra DB here on third down. Throwing, Love. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. They'll get 11, but still a little short, fourth down.
And when you're throwing the ball downfield really well, like they have been on this drive, it's really a nice time to work one of the screen plays in. One of my favorite play callers in the game is he starts every game with 10 to 12 screens because if he starts feeling the pressure from the defense, he uses their aggressiveness against them.
And this one is right through. So Love gets him down inside the 5, but ultimately they settle for just the field goal.
To think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the 3, and I think it was a smart move.
So now Carlson, after the touchdown, called on to send this one away. Taken at the goal line. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. Khalif Raymond, he's inside the 20. And he'll bring it back all the way. Touchdown, Lions. So they gave up the field goal, but boom, they get it right back. Don't even worry about getting their offense on the field. They return it on the kickoff.
So I see your 3 points.
And raise you.
And raise you 6. Double it up, coming right back at them. And if that's going to be the trade all game long, someone's going to be very happy with the end result.
Riley Patterson now for the extra point. Now these are not going to be easy on a cold, snowy night, but this one is up and through.
Personal foul. Roughing the kicker. Defense.
And that flag accepted. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased, and they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And
take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Jordan Love ready on first down here. And that is going to be incomplete as he let him a bit too much. Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
They'll throw again. Here's Love on 2nd and 10. His throw incomplete.
A couple of quick incompletions, and now they're just one more away from getting off the field. They've got options now. Could they dial up a blitz here? Or just drop everyone into coverage to crowd the throwing lanes?
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. To pass, here's Jordan Love. And that is incomplete. But the pressure there on 3rd down, forcing the errant pass. 4th down coming up.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that tuck rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. O'Donnell, he's on to punt as he gets this one away. It's a 42-yard punt. They keep him to just a yard on the return. And the Lions will take over. The Lions offense getting ready to go to work here. And under center, a man whose career has been rejuvenated a bit as of late. And season number 8 now out of Cal, it's Jared Goff.
Rumors of Goff's demise? Greatly exaggerated, it seems. Boy, what a big year he had last year. 29 touchdowns. It led the Lions to their first winning season since 2017. Under his leadership, the Lions expect to make the playoffs for the first time in a few seasons.
Now Goff on 1st down. Completing it here to Marvin Jones. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down.
Brings up 2nd and a yard at the 40-yard line.
Ball on the 40 now. Here's 2nd and a yard. Now the former goal. This is David Montgomery. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 7 yards there and a 1st down.
Montgomery with a good game there, and he broke 800 yards for the Bears' NFL best ground game last season. Divisional rival Detroit took notice and brought him in to boost their growing offense.
Here's the 12th overall pick in April's draft, Jahmyr Gibbs. And this will be taken across midfield and into Green Bay territory. He'll get 4 yards of the carry there, and we will get to the end of the first quarter of play. After 1-7-3, the score on EA Sports. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Goff now to throw. And this throw incomplete. That time, but it's going to lead to 3rd down. But he came through for that nice drive. No surprise that they were hoping he could do it again. So after the 2nd down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Goff.
Even keeping the back end for extra protection on 3rd down, they still could prevent the sack. Now it's 4th and long thanks to a terrific individual effort on defense.
On 4th down. On to punt for Detroit. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And this one sails out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25. It will. 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from
that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they threw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60%.
Well, the pressure gets to Love, and he'll go down. Aleem McNeil, his second sack of the night. Well, it was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving them exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He finds Watson complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15. I love that play, because in the snow you think run, run, run. Big passing play there.
And defenders hate it, especially in open space, because trying to come under control, break down, and make a tackle in the open field, difficult in normal conditions. In these conditions, almost impossible.
Love going to give this one to Jones. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
Ball spotted at the 45. Here's second down and seven. They'll go again to Jones. And this will be a Packers first down as good running gets him to about the 44.
And they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went three and out.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Up the middle, Jones. And he's going to be stopped at the 37. Solid run on first down. Gain of seven leaves him with a second and three.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. They'll bring a tight end in motion left. On second down, Dillon. And this time not quite to the 30. He'll be down at the 31-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
You watch Dillon run there, and he looks just like an enforcer for the Packers offense. And he is. He gets the ball, and you know you're in store for a punishing powerful run. Almost 1,600 yards over the last two seasons on the ground.
An inside give to Jones. And he fights forward for a modest two-yard gain, second down.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that gain.
Got it here at the 29 on second and eight. Switching things up, they'll throw it now with Jordan Love. He'll drop this underneath for Jones. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of five. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
2 minutes to play in this first half, 7-3, our score. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. So here now the rookie sixth-rounder, Anders Carlson, for the Packer field goal. He connected on his first, this from 41. And his kick is indeed good. And they'll get it back with a point at 7-6. So the Hodge and Shrinks have been his back-to-back drives here for him and the field goals.
Yeah, we know no one's turning down three, especially in the
Johnson to send it away. And he returns this to the 22. Back onto the field come the Lions for their second overall drive. As we eat closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like, because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
On first and 10, Goff. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
That's only trying to do a play call. They were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now gone. Throw to St. Brown, complete on the left side. And he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. Throwing on third, Goff. And that is incomplete.
And that is how you respond after taking one on the chin to begin this game. Give up a first drive touchdown, go back out on defense, and completely shut them down to force a 3-and-out.
Jack Fox out to punt here on fourth down. And he'll send this one into the cold Lambeau night. Fair catch called for and taken right near the 30-yard line. A 41-yard punt there with no return. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. Scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. On play action, love to throw. That's going to be caught downfield by Reed. Getting it to him in space, pays off big time. That winds up going for 31.
What my dad would say sometimes, I'm just scratching my head here trying to figure out what was going on there defensively. How did you lose him in the middle of the field? If you're going to lose a receiver, make sure it's someone on the short side of things, not deep downfield, that can hurt your defense.
Got his man complete over the middle. It's Jones. And he's brought down at the 19 after a game of 19. First down in the red zone.
Well, it certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we could capitalize on him getting the ball possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
I'm really liking what I'm seeing from this defense, because their coverage has been playing at a shutdown level so far, even backed up late. They're forcing incompletions and fighting to keep them out of the end zone as the first half winds down.
Love. He sets up the screen to Jones. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. A third field goal of the first half, not what they're looking for as they come up on third down. Love now. Down shy of the first down marker at the 11. Pretty solid gain of 7 yards that time as he scrambled, but now they face a fourth down. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call.
Come on, baby.
Come on, make
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And his kick is good. And they drop back in front here. It's 9-7. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's 3 field goals for him now.
And not just 3 field goals, but 3 for 3. So even though the offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, he's still been able to come away with points due to his leg.
So barring a touchback, this likely the final act of the half as the kick is away. So we're at halftime here at Lambeau with the Packers taking the lead to the break. As we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome everyone to our brand new studios here in downtown Orlando in the EA Sports Halftime Report. The big story thus far has really been the snow. It's made footing treacherous. And if the forecast holds, it's only going to get worse. But I can tell you as a fan, these are the games you love to watch.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. Has changed since we left you at halftime. The snow still continuing to fall as we are back underway. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number 3. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter 3.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Position has had to focus on defending the pass here. We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
Back to the air, Goff on second down. Packer pressure, and down he goes. A safety blitz turns out to be a great call defensively as they sack him for a loss of 9.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
So now following the sack, Goff and the Lions needing to come up with something here on third and long. Looking to throw. And the pressure gets to him again. Preston Smith comes in for the sack.
And that's the Preston Smith, the Green Bay Packers cap line. Someone who can come off the edge and get after the quarterback. 3-year run with the Packers has been excellent. 8.5 sacks in 2022.
Here comes the Lions punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. It's a 45-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. Will come the offense as they take over. So here are the Packers now. They get set for their first possession of half number 2. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. And he's going to get it across the midfield stripe in the line territory. 43 yards on the ground for him so far.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Ball on the 47-yard line. Here's second and four.
Build that momentum.
Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Yeah, every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
Our partner knows these runs individually, man. It helps out a whole lot.
Now three plays, all three short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
Love now to pass on first down. In trouble, and he's taken down. Alex Anzalone coming in for that outside linebacker spot, and he buries him for a loss of 7. But found his way into the backfield, and he simply would not be denied.
Well, they say that life's all about opportunities, and that holds true when you're playing defense as well. How about him seeing that chance, making the most of it, did a great job of wrapping him up and bringing him down.
A gain there of 21 yards.
Time to get some credit to the big fellas, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on passing routes, because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
Well, these Packers and these Packer fans really thrive in the cold temperatures here at Lambeau, and their guys have the lead here with a first and 10. Here's Love, and his throw is incomplete.
Offense is moving them a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they're on a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Third quarter of a two-point game, a good one so far. Here's second and 10. Love looking to throw it. And his throw here is incomplete. Right now, the story of this game continuing to be the defenses, because the offenses, they're finding it difficult to establish any rhythm whatsoever.
I like how you come to us in praise of defense, Brandon, because that's exactly right. That was an incompletion for us there, but we've seen it throughout this game. Both of these defense coordinators, they're a step ahead of their offensive counterparts.
Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third.
That was well defended. They clamped down on every available receiver. Just got to give the win to the defense on that snap.
So here now the rookie sixth-rounder, Anders Carlson, for the Packer field goal. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. And his kick is good. Power pushed the lead up to 12-7. So he's got another field goal. His fourth now in the game. He's making it look easy out there.
He certainly is, and they're always aiming for a swing of the leg that repeats under pressure, right? So nothing's different. He's got that right now because confidence is breeding confidence.
Back out there now to send this one away. This taken in at the goal line. Oh, a good looking return set up here. He's past the 30. He will score. Touchdown, Lions.
Again, Elvin Barton, I've got to get fired up. Two kickoff returns for touchdowns in the same game. This is fun to watch.
Yeah, we call a lot of games at a lot of different places. Sometimes it seems like we do it simultaneously, but we rarely get to see this. Goff and that Lions offense staying on the field. They'll try for two. They'll try and throw for it. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Green Bay offense ready to take over. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. First down, going to the air with Love. So the completion good for seven there. And it's second down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
On second down, it's Jones. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handle it a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones to about the 33-yard line.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
From the 33, here's second and six. From the shotgun, a give to Jones. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. Give him 15 there, and the Packers have a first. Here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now at Lambeau. After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. And we've got a dandy here. A 1-point game as we begin the fourth. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves them with 2 to go on second down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. To throw now, here's Love. He'll find his tight end here, DeGuara. And he stopped after a gain of 1, not enough, still a yard to go on third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They tackle them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
He's got the open man. That's Musgrave. And he's going to have the Packers' first down as they're able to convert by 20 there on third and 1.
They brought in a heavy set on third down, and that usually means running play, but we have seen them throw out of that formation. And sure enough, they snuck the tight end out on that one, wound up hitting him for a first down.
Keep it going. That ball down the field.
They go back to the ground with Jones. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Jack Campbell, a first-round pick there on the tackle.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call them, run fits, everyone was in the right place.
Here's Jones again on second down. And he is met in his
tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to third and 10.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. On third down, Love. And this is going to be incomplete.
We've got to give out a little applause on that play. It has to go to the defense. More good work by them. They've taken away the passing lanes all game long, and you can see the frustration that it's causing because he just about threw that one into the first row.
For the Packers field goal, a 54-yard attempt.
And he missed it. It's no good, and that'll keep this a one-point game.
Now, if this was a clear day in September, I'd say this is well within his range. I'd feel very confident about this kick, but let's be honest about it. In these elements, the difficulty level gets ratcheted up by at least a factor of five.
Detroit's offense ready to take over. They certainly caught a big break with that missed field goal. Instead of trailing, they hold on to that slim lead, and now we'll see how they play this critical fourth quarter possession. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 44. Out of the gun, Goff. A little short pass here taken in by Laporta. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And that will bring up second down.
It's vitally important to wrap him up immediately because if you let that big guy get a head of steam up, boy, then you've got real trouble trying to get him down.
But they're able to hold him to a short gain on first down. St. Brown in motion right. Here's Goff now on second down. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
The coverage was good, but I just wonder if they actually pulled the quarterback on that play. I think he was expecting something else. And no one knew where to throw the football successfully.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down.
Their chances of closing this one out. Now they're going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
And here now the punter Fox as he sends this one away. Taking it about the 16. A nice punt, but a good run back as well, 13 yards. And they will take over first and 10. So here's Love and the Packers down by one. 2:25 remaining. Plenty of time here. They've got three timeouts and the two-minute warning as they've got it first and 10. Jordan Love ready on first down here. That's taken in. Fourth quarter, 2 minutes on the clock in a tight one-point game. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. And not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up second down.
Not in a position where they absolutely have to rush right now, but they definitely have to pick up the tempo a bit.
Another try, second and 10 now. Here's Love. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I don't know if you need a big shot right there or not because you've still got time to work some of the shorter stuff. And
try to get into field goal range. They did go for the big one there. It would have been nice, but it winds up incomplete.
Well, the elements, the crowd, the situation, this is NFL football at its best. Here's third down. Shifts by him. And he will get this to the midfield stripe, but that's not going to be enough. He's a few yards short. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
It's going to be a good day, boys.
Too far for a field goal. They've got to go. It's fourth down. Desperation time here. Love on fourth down. And this is caught, they say, out of bounds. A little bit of first down, but he couldn't stay in, and as a result, they're going to have to give up the football. So now let's reset here, Charles. They do have two timeouts left, so they can stop the clock twice. This one's not quite over yet.
No, and what you're doing on defense, you're going to use both timeouts, obviously. But you've got to call defenses are going to force the issue early, meaning you want that play over fast. You don't want to give them time to dance around in the backfield or run away.
And I believe the referee's been buzzed. Yeah, they want to take another look at this call, and it's certainly a big one here late in a tight game. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Here's the call. So the folks in New York just going to wind up confirming what the official saw as this play will stand as is. So good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. We got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Figure the rush is going to be fierce again as they come up second and 13. Gibbs straight ahead. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. We'll see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. On third down, they go Montgomery. Oh, springs free. Montgomery loses it. Oh, one of the linebackers has got it. And they have possession. And they have it at the 38-yard line.
I know you're looking at the scoreboard clock. We're getting near the end of this game. But they were in what was really called four-minute offense.
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure.
Previous play is under review.
Now, the question, was the knee, in fact, down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
After reviewing the play,
so that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. Goff with a kneel down here, and that should put a conclusion to this one.
And how about this finish? Able to take a knee, run out the clock, and close this game out. By one point. You talk about how many coaches we talked to. They all said the same. All I wanted to do is win by one point. That got tested in this one.
Yep, and that cliche rings true. A single penny separates this one. Well, you really can't ask for much more than what we just had here. Not only a close game that went down to the wire, Charles, but a clean one, too. No turnovers in this contest.
And I think you're exactly right about that. To me, this is just a pair of offenses trying to find the slightest bit of separation from each other. And they were both hoping that the other side would make the big mistake first. But today, neither side made that mistake. And what we got, a very entertaining game throughout.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. From Lambeau, good night, everybody.